guys, and welcome back to my channel. So I actually filmed this video on TikTok, and then I realized later, after like I threw away everything, that I wanted to film it on YouTube. So that's why all the clips are going to be like, you know, like the vertical TikTok-y form. But I wanted to talk about it on YouTube because I don't really think I'm able to like tell all the backstory and like the more, you know, like just like go more in depth with the products than I can on TikTok. I'm almost out of my heat protectant that I've been constantly using, and I need something that is a liquid form so I can travel with it, because I also really like this dry, the dry bar one, but this is like an aerosol, so I can't really travel with it. And with all the aerosol issues going on in the industry right now and the recalls, I'm kind of like, I just don't want to use aerosols anymore. Is there another heat protectant spray out there that's better? Maybe a little bit cheaper than this one. I think this one's about like $20, but I've been using this for years and I feel like my hair just always looks so straight with it. I kind of picked up three other ones on Amazon that had really good ingredients or were a really good price, because I'm like, well, if it like works really well and it's a cheap price, like might as well like take it. So the ones I kind of like narrowed down on were this hair food heat protection spray, and the ingredients are really clean and really good. It has argan oil, coconut oil. The other one I was interested in was this Eva NYC 10-in-1 primer. Argan oil, sunflower seed oil. The ingredients in this one are the cleanest and it's just so simple, so I wanted to give this a try. And then this L'Oreal Sleek It Iron Spray. This was like super cheap. Not the best ingredients at all, but I was like, might as well, you know, just might as well give it a try. In order to test them out, I decided to put them on pieces of bread and then put them in the oven and like see how well they performed. So I have one piece of bread that's completely plain, and then the other ones I sprayed each of the different heat protectant sprays on them. Popped it in the oven at 425 degrees because a lot of these products claim that it protects your hair up to 450 degrees. I definitely would do it probably around the 400 because my hair is so thick and coarse, it needs to have some high heat on it. And I basically just kept checking on it with like the light, because I honestly wasn't sure how long I should be leaving this in for, because if you think about it, you're not like leaving 425 degrees onto a piece of your hair at like a time, like minutes on end. So I was like, okay, I'll just like, you know, just keep an eye on it. And when I took out the bread, I was shocked. So the reason why I had one piece of bread as like with nothing on it is the standard. So basically that's gonna show like what the heat is going to do to your hair. And then all the other ones are gonna show how well it protects the hair. Ideally, the bread comes out and it's like lighter than the standard, because that means it showed that there was some heat protection going on. And I was just mind blown by these two in particular. First of all, this one, you can see where I sprayed the product onto the bread and that it's way more burnt, which is freaking me out, because that's not protecting your hair. That's making your hair like frying your hair even worse. And I've been using this product for so long, absolutely never purchasing this again. Do not buy this. It does not protect your hair at all. Same goes for the L'Oreal. It did the exact same thing as a sleep matrix. How did this pass R&D? I wonder how their product development team actually like tested out how well it like protects your hair, because the proof is in the bread. Like, these are not good. Bad. Do not use them, absolutely not. The dry bar one did a really good job at protecting that your hair, or not hair, but you know, the toast. You know, this is aerosol, so we're just gonna never, you know, we're not gonna have that one in running. So the last two remaining that actually did a really good job is the hair food and the Eva NYC. I'm like so happy to see that there are actually products out there that are actually going to protect your hair when they have these claims on it, and not make your hair like completely worse like the other ones. So if I compare these two pieces of bread, I will have to say that I think the hair food actually did a better job at protecting the bread than the Eva NYC, but this one still did a really good job. So I'll probably just end up like really using both of these up, but when it comes to repurchasing, I'm not really sure exactly which one I want to keep, because I like them for both different reasons. I personally like that the ingredients list of the Eva NYC is so clean and natural. I'm really like a fan of that. I also think it gives your hair like a really nice shine. I used the Eva NYC one today. And I love that it has a trigger sprayer and it comes in an aluminum component, so it's like less plastic. And the trigger sprayers are just so much easier to use on your hair versus kind of like a push top, your standard kind of sprayer like this, the hair food one has. I also really do like the smell of it. It's not too obnoxious. It doesn't linger in my hair at all. So I don't know. I really do like this, but I do feel like the hair food one definitely did a better job at heat protecting the bread. So I feel like this one's actually a little bit more efficacious. The only thing I don't like that it doesn't have a trigger sprayer, but that's something I could easily, you know, solve. This one also doesn't have an obnoxious smell to it too, which I'm very sensitive to smells, so I really like that. But it's not my favorite smell. It smells like shampoo, tropical shampoo. Not bad, not great. In terms of pricing, this one's a little bit more expensive than the hair food. I'll put the prices on the screen. I'll put the price per ounces on the screen because that's what you should really be focusing on when you're purchasing products, because sometimes high-end actually is a better value than drugstore. Sometimes, not all the time. But if you are really looking for something to protect your hair, I definitely think these two are the ones. This one did better, but then this one has a better like user experience and formula. So kind of up to you. I hope you guys kind of enjoyed that like fun like science experiment. I had so much fun doing it. It kind of makes me want to like go out and buy more hair protection sprays and like do it on like more bread. That's it for my video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will talk to you guys in my next. Bye.